I'm sure you remember how to get the slope of a line. Suppose that we have a line here. Maybe we'll draw a coordinate axes. We've got a line here, and you've got a point, and you've got another point, and you want to understand what the slope is. So you draw the distance here, and this height you call the rise, and the width you call the run, and the slope is the rise divided by the run. Now, to use the notation that we've been using before, if this is the x-axis, and this is the y-axis, and this is the curve y equals f of x, it happens to be a straight line, but it's a function, then the rise is what we call the change in y. It's how much y changed when you went from here to here. And the run is the change in x. So the slope is delta y over delta x. Okay, now in calculus, in algebra you learn how to deal with things that are constant. Constant velocities, constant acceleration, various things that are constant. In calculus we learn how to deal with quantities that are always changing. So let's suppose that we've got a curve. I'm going to take the curve y equals x squared. And it goes through the point 1, 1. And we want to understand how fast is this curve rising. So you want to know how steep it is, so you want to pick a line that comes as close as possible to approximating what this curve is doing right there. And you want to know what is the slope of that line. So you need 2 points to determine a line, and we've only got 1 point. So what we're going to do is we're going to take a nearby point over here and draw the straight line there. Now the straight line is not going to, cuts across. So this is a point x, x squared, and we can figure out how much x has changed. We'll call that delta x. We'll figure out how much y has changed. We'll call it delta y. And this is not called a tangent line. This is called a secant line. As far as I know, that word doesn't have anything to do with the trig function secant, but maybe there's some obscure connection. In any case, this secant line, if you take its slope, that's a pretty good approximation to the slope of the tangent line. So slope of the secant line is delta y over delta x. The slope of the tangent line, which is how steep is the whole curve, is the limit as you take closer and closer and closer points. See, if I take this point and this point, I'm not getting a very good approximation. If I take this point and this point, I get a better approximation. This and this, I get better. This and this, I get better. And it doesn't matter which side I take it on. If I take 2 points that are really, really close together, then the secant line between them is going to be really close to the tangent line. So you take a limit as delta x goes to 0, and that's the slope of the tangent line. So let's do that for the case of our curve. So drawing it again. Here we are at 1, 1, and here's another point, x, x squared. So delta x is x minus 1. It's how much, the change in x is x minus 1 because this is at x and this is 1. The change in y is x squared minus 1. So delta y over delta x is x squared minus 1 over x minus 1, and that's x plus 1. The slope of the tangent line, which we call f prime of 1, is the limit as delta x approaches 0, in other words, the limit as x gets closer and closer and closer to 1, of x plus 1, and that's 2. So the slope of the tangent line here is 2. For any value of x that's bigger than, if I take the secant line, it'll have a slope bigger than 2. If I take this secant line, it'll have a slope less than 2. But the tangent line has a slope exactly to, which we get by taking a limit of the secant lines as they get closer and closer and closer to the tangent line.